what do you want to make? I looked at Peter. Peter looked at me and said, oh, yeah, what do we want to make? So on the side, he had a pair of biker boots. And I said, well, let's make a pair of biker boots. But on a winkle picker last. Let's make them in white leather, you know? And these abortions of shoes, boots came out. And we made one. We put it in the shop. And Marco Peroni came in, who...
From Adam and the Ants.
Yeah, he wasn't in Adam and the Ants at the time. He'd just forming a band called The Models. And I think they had a record out later, Man of the Year and Freeze. And he loved them and he bought them. I actually contacted Marco to see if he still had them for the exhibition, but he didn't.
He kept a lot of stuff, though, Marco. Yeah, yeah. He's a real collector.
Yeah, he's
isn't
got
he?
Loads of Vivian Westwood, hasn't he? You know, he had a pair of black paint and pirate biker boots from us. He's still got them.
The you had the King's Road shop.
Yeah.
As well, sort of
yeah.
Down at World's End. And
yeah.
There, at that stage, there was what, yourself, there was Vivian around the corner,
yeah.
There was, I guess, Boy was down
yeah.
there.
Anthony Price.
Anthony Price was yeah. there. There'd been Acme Attractions just
yeah.
up the road.
And the Beaufort Market with Smuts and all those people in there.
There, I mean, it was a real kind of hotbed at that
yeah,
period,
yeah.
wasn't it?
Yeah. And there was one very out-of-place person in there, which was Carlo Manzi, selling amazing Ivy League suits, you know. And I got a lot of the stuff from the exhibition, the early stuff from Carlo Manzi.
Who hires it all out. Doesn't
yeah,
he makes
yeah.
a living out of
I mean,
doing...
it's amazing. Have you been to
I've
his
been
place?
To his place. Yeah. I went there and got a teddy boy
yeah,
outfit
yeah.
for a party I was going
fantastic
to.
Place.
Yeah, it is a wonderful place.
Yeah.
Do you still... I mean, they're obviously good memories. Do you still like clothes? Do you still kind of...
What do you think?
Well, I can see the way you're dressed, yeah. I mean, you've come in, I would say, late 1969, early 1970 skinhead, sort of.
No, I wouldn't say that at all. It's actually almost Jivey Ivy.
Well, the shirt isn't, yeah. though.
Well, it's collegey, isn't it?
Yeah,
really,
I guess so.
I suppose, you know, Paisley.
But you're obviously still into it. Would
yeah.
would you do a shop again, or is those days gone, do you think?
I wouldn't want the financial hassle, the VAT visit,
sure.
All that. But, I mean, people keep saying, we need you to come back, but, I mean...
Because there's nothing like it out
no,
there, is it?
No, there's no one taking a risk. Everything's bland, you know.
Why
all
is
using
it? We seem to have got into a really conservative era,
well,
clothes-wise.
I think that the big companies have taken over. If there are a few... small companies that are very well documented in a magazine called Men's File. And, you know, there's places like Derek Harris at Lewis Leathers that have opened up again,
yeah.
you know, and things like that. There are places around, but you have to search. You have to know what you're looking for.
Tell people what they can see at the exhibition. What does it consist of?
Well, it starts in... it starts from about 1968 when we... it was the second place we had in Kensington Market. The first place was called the Heavy Metal Kids. And we, before the term was used for rock
for the
and
band,
roll,
yeah.
I think Pat Cockle got it from a John Steinbeck novel or something
right.
like that. And when we started the Heavy Metal Kids, the store was like all filled in, like it was in a corner and there was two walls and it had an oval shape cut out of it and the door was a plug, right? And it was all painted silver with upholstery tacks around it, so it looked like a submarine. And inside it was all totally Victorian Art Nouveau, with two wonderful high back chairs and a chest of drawers with Newman jeans and Westaway and Westaway Shetlands flying out of the drawers. And then we moved to a bigger site in 1968 in the market. And we decided to take the mickey out of the likes of Turnbull and Asser and all the rest of it. And we called it Cockle and Johnson, established 68. And that's when we started properly manufacturing.
And so what do you see in the exhibition? Do you see that?
Are you see, yeah, you've got a good amount of Cockle and Johnson, and the name changed a bit later to Johnson and Johnson.
Yep.
So you see that. There's a very early advert, pornographic advert, that Pat Cockle put into Oz magazine. And I think artworks out of the same advert, this advert was 1968, artworks out of the same advert were used by Vivian Westwood many, many years later. There's the original poster that we did for the tube trains, which was rather brave of us at the time to do an advertising thing on the tubes. There's printed jackets. There's the best thing in the exhibition for me is the photograph of Fred Astaire wearing my Fred Astaire jacket.
And a very nice photograph of yourself on that scooter that you used to have as
well.
Yeah,
yeah.
Have you still got the scooter?
No. I sold it long ago. But you can see I was very put out by having my photo taken.
Yeah. I have to say, you look very cool, Lloyd, then, and you still do now. Yeah. Tell us about the place. Where it's the Chelsea Space Gallery. What is that? Where is it?
Well, it's a very spearhead gallery. They try and do people and things that are obscure, and I think a lot of people look to that gallery to get inspiration in a lot of the bigger galleries.
Well, I tell you what, I don't think Lloyd Johnson ever was obscure, because lots and lots of Londoners came and kind of livened up their lives I think.
Thank you.
If you're an old customer of Lloyd's, get yourself down, or even if you're not, if you want to see what it was like back in the glory days, it's Lloyd Johnson, the Modern Outfitter, which is at the Chelsea Space Gallery until March the 23rd. And if you put in www.chelseaspace.org, you'll find it in there. Do you know what? I still want that leather jacket you've got on the cover there. I never got myself. I don't think I could ever afford one. I used to come and ogle it. One day I'll get one.
Okay.
Lloyd, it's lovely to see you, sir.
Okay, thank you.
It's just approaching 1:30 here on the Robert Elms Show on BBC London 94.9 FM. That's just about it. We're done.